public better informed about all government affairs.
That's a good question. Communication is a real big issue. In the day of in the digital age that we're in now, emails are sent out to websites, but that's not enough to get the message out. You know, we need to have a multi-pronged communication skills. Communication. It can't just be one way or another. You have to be out of the door. You got to be talking to people. You got to send emails out. You got to. You have to be able to update your website. Things need to be all connected together. It cannot just be one or the other. So what I would do is make sure that we have all those types of things. We have a couple, but they're not updated all the time. Emails are not always the best way. It doesn't get to everybody. It doesn't spam. That's why going to the residents, speaking to you, and going to the door, I understand the concerns. So those are something that, as council person, that I would keep doing. It's not just something you do during election time. Thank you.
I agree with Justin. I think it's important to visit as many people as possible, to visit where people gather. But our young people, it's very important that we engage them. And there's nothing better than social media for our young people. I mean, there was a time we'd sit home and watch the news, but now our young people have every app in the world, every device in the world to get information. And it's important that we engage them. So using I'm not even current on them, Instagram, Facebook, Periscope, I think it's called. But finding every way possible to engage young people in the process. And then having town hall meetings in the communities, in the wards, and hearing the issues that are most sensitive to the people. And then especially visiting with our seniors and talking with the seniors and letting them communicate and making sure they understand what is being shared. So I think it's a multi-pronged process. And encouraging people to participate at every level is very important.
Thank you. Hillary?
Certainly social media is a necessary component in, you know, trying to engage people in your community, but I do recognize, I plan to have a website, but I also recognize that not everyone is online. So what's important is for you to be out in the community. I think it's important for us to have neighborhood leaders so that we can effectively, you know, disperse information to all of the neighborhoods within our wards so that no one is missing. Because, I mean, as a lifelong resident, one of the things that I've noticed is that sometimes there's information that we just miss. And it could be someone on the next street and all of them have the information, but our block missed it. And it shouldn't be that way. And the way that you can eliminate that as an issue is by being involved with the people and coming out all the time to socialize among your people and know what's going on and effectively communicate.
You know, Hillary's right. You know, Morristown is a community of neighborhoods, great neighborhoods. I think the biggest task we have is actually getting people out and getting people involved. The more people that are involved, the more people are going to be in the know. And involvement is probably the best means of communication. Just think about it. How many texts, how many emails do you get a day? Do you really pay attention to them? Probably not. But when that neighbor reaches out to you, and when you get involved, that's when you're truly listening, truly understanding what's going on in our community. I'm thinking back, when was I most informed about what was going on in my neighborhood? It was when my kids were involved with athletics. You were out on the fields, you were talking with your neighbors. And also, in this campaign, walking, it just amazed me sometimes, especially in the apartment buildings, how many people don't get out. And we really have to, as a community, reach out, get those people involved, and so they're also in the know, like we're going to be in the know. Thank you.
Okay. There we go. So we live in some interesting times now. We talk about the digital age, which is exactly where we are, but we're at a gap. Yes, we talk about our younger generation with all the different applications to stay on top of everything in milliseconds. But we also have the older generation who just have no interest in using that. So it's important, and I'll be the first to say, social media is key. But for the people who choose not to act and use that, grassroots kind of information, knock on doors, make those phone calls, And that's what I would do. I have a loud voice for people who know me. I'm also a runner, so I can be sure I will run to your house if I have to. I'm gonna knock on that door, and I'm gonna let you know what's going on, because you still have to bridge that gap. Or not even bridge it, it's okay, you don't have to bridge the gap. Different strokes for different folks. Younger generation, digital age is great. Older generation, you choose not to go that way, better be knocking on those doors and making phone calls. Thank you.
I have a track record with communications at all levels. I guess it started with my undergrad degree to prepare me in radio and television communications. But when we had the hurricane, I went door to door and instituted a survey, of which I drafted myself, and I submitted it to JCP&L and organized all the comments, and that feedback was directly used to improve the crisis communications for future disasters. I presented the findings of that survey at the public hearing, at the JCP&L public hearing. That was going door to door. I also went door to door in my community, where I live in Windmill Pond, where I've lived for 17 years, and communicated with my residents, my fellow neighbors, and went door to door last year this time when there was a controversial decision that came up. So I went door to door to improve the quality of life of our neighborhood. I have a track record. I've organized neighborhood meetings. I bring the mayor and the administration to meet with the neighbors, as well as Facebook posts. And I will say that 4 years ago when I ran, I said I would get a Facebook page, because I'm one of those that doesn't just jump on that social media wagon. And I guess sitting here tonight, I will get an iPhone, I promise, and I will text, because I know that that bugs a lot of you, but my husband has an unlimited data plan, so I'm kind of caught in between that. But I will promise to get an iPhone, and I promise I will text.
Thank you very much. We're now ready.